Hi BTN, my name's Melanie. I'm going to tell you about cystic fibrosis, also known as CF. But first, I'm going to tell you a little bit about myself.
I'm 12 years old and I live in Adelaide with my mum, my dad and my dog Rosie, and my cats Oliver and Cleo, wherever they are. I love hanging out with my friends, riding motorbikes and playing netball. And yep, I have cystic fibrosis. In Australia, one in 2,500 babies are born with CF. It mostly affects the lungs and digestive system. It makes my cells create thick, sticky mucus inside my airways and where I process food. It's a genetic condition, which means it's caused by a difference in my genes or DNA, and it's something you're born with.
CF can sometimes feel like if you were breathing through a straw continuously, and on hot days, it can be really tiring and difficult to breathe after just running around for a little bit. There are some days where I have to miss school for clinic appointments, or even if it's just a really bad day where my stomach might hurt, or if there's just difficulty breathing.
Most people are diagnosed as babies. My parents found out when I was only 8 days old.
What was it like when you found out I had cystic fibrosis?
Oh, it was really hard, Chicky. You spent the first 2 months of life in hospitals, but we learned all about cystic fibrosis and how to give you your medications as a little baby and how to do your treatments on your lungs to try and keep them healthy. So what's all the medications that you take every day, Melody? Can you remember them all, what they do?
I take salt tablets, I take Abdec, which is vitamins, Creon, which is my food, and Trikafta, which is a new medication.
Yeah, don't forget your puffers.
Oh yeah.
And all of your nebulizers.
Oh yeah. This is my nebulizer, and I'm gonna put it together. I do this nebulizer twice a day for 30 minutes. This is hypothetic saline. It's like salty water.
This helps to thin the mucus and to help me cough it up. I also have to do physio. Exercise also really helps, so I like to play with Rosie, ride my bike, and play sport. Because CF affects my gut too, it means that my body struggles to absorb nutrients and I can get stomach aches. So I have to take special tablets every time I eat to help. I also have to eat a high fat, high calorie, high salt diet. That means more foods like milkshakes, chips, hummus, and takeaway, as well as fruit and veg and stuff that everyone needs to eat.
Takeaway food may not be the best for you, but for me, it can really help with salt, fat, and calories.
My body's always working extra hard to do everything it needs to do to keep me going, so I'm also way more likely to get sick.
A small cold for you could mean a trip into hospital for me. Hospital for me is surgery with a PICC line into my arm and many, many doses of antibiotics.
Sometimes when I get really sick, I have to stay in hospital for 4 to 5 days.
Going into hospital is not fun. It's really annoying and boring and can sometimes be a little bit painful. The only good part's the food, but you don't want to go in there just for food.
But luckily after that, I can come home to do my treatments instead of at hospital, although it is pretty tricky. The good news is there's research going into treating and even finding a cure for CF. I've just started taking new medication that's actually targeting my cells and helping them to function properly. And that's now helping me to live an even better life.
The longest I've stayed in hospital was 3 weeks, and the last time I went in was 2019. I haven't had to go back since 2019 because I've been able to keep myself nice and healthy. I'd really like other kids to be more aware and that this can affect the rest of my life. They're a little bit sick, maybe just to keep their distance, just to be safe, and that this is really serious. Thanks, BTN. I hope you learnt a little bit more about cystic fibrosis.